Let's now discuss about ferromagnetic materials. We already studied about diamagnetic and paramagnetic materials. And these are the third kind of materials which are extensively used in normal practice. Let's write something about ferromagnetic materials. Here we can write that in some specific materials like iron, cobalt, nickel, some more such materials are there in which atoms have non-zero magnetic moments, just like paramagnetic materials where also atoms have net non-zero magnetic moments. But in this situation, there is one difference compared to paramagnetic materials which we can write, which have non-zero magnetic moments, and in the solid lattice, due to a quantum phenomena, this phenomena is called exchange coupling. Atomic groups are formed in different pockets of material which have the magnetic moments align in same direction in that group. But one more thing here, we can see that all these groups are having randomized directions. Like let us first draw the material. Say if this is a ferromagnetic material, this picture will make the concept better. Like in this small pocket, all atoms have their dipole moment in the same direction. In this packet, again, dipole moments have same direction. In this packet, again, these dipole moments have same direction. So we can say in this manner, different pockets are formed where all atoms have their dipoles aligned in same direction. It is basically because of a phenomena by which individual atoms influence their neighboring atoms, and all these align themselves in the same direction. So these pockets have net non-zero magnetic moments, but as we can see here, different pockets have their dipole moments aligned in different directions. So on an average here we can say the total magnetic moment, if we calculate the total magnetic moment of this material, which is summation of mu I vector from I equals to 1 to n for all atoms or even for all pockets, this will always be 0 because these directions are randomly distributed in different directions. And here each of these atomic groups are called, these are given a specific name called domains. So here we can say in a domain, all dipole moments are aligned in a specific direction, and such materials are called ferromagnetic materials. The most important thing about ferromagnetic materials is these are highly sensitive about external applied magnetic field. When externally a magnetic field is applied, these are highly sensitive, and with a very small field due to exchange coupling, all domains align in the direction of field. That we'll study in next section about the magnetization of ferromagnetic materials.